mother came home, she said, Slick, which was my daddy's nickname, your boy been up at the school being a smart aleck. Now, I already know I'm going to get a whooping for this. She said, tell him what you wrote on your paper. And I said, I want to be on TV. And my father said, well, what's wrong with that? And she said, well, he being a smart aleck and putting something like that that's unbelievable on the paper. So my father said, Bill, how come the boy can't put on the paper he want to be on TV? So they were starting to get into an argument, so I got sent to my room, which I knew what that meant. That means go in your room, get ready. We're going to get this whooping, right? So I go in my room, and after having a discussion, my father came in the room. He said, all right, this is what I want you to do. What does she want you to put on your paper? I said, I don't know, Daddy, like a basketball player, what all the rest of the kids wrote. He said, well, put that on the paper. Take that to school tomorrow and give it to her. Take your paper and put it in your drawer. Every morning when you get up, read your paper. And every night before you go to bed, read your paper. That's your paper. What he told me was a principle of success, that if you write it down and envision it, anything you see in your mind, you can hold in your hand. He knew that. And so he gave that to me. After that, every year when the teacher was living, I used to send her a TV because I wanted her to see me. She saw me one year and she said, boy, you send me all these TV from wherever you are and you don't understand, I got too many TV. I have to get these TVs away sometime. I know, it's all right though. And I kept that paper. And that little boy with the stuttering problem is on TV 7 days a week. Yeah. I'm on TV. All the time. You dig?